And you can see that the clients are being created. Wow, and I have a dashboard. That is pretty impressive. At Business Automated, we build Airtable systems for everything. Managing factories, tracking sales, or even generating content with AI. But last week I discovered that I can be replaced with AI. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated, and on this channel, we help you save time and money with useful solutions to automate your business. If you have not already, consider subscribing. That helps us produce more useful videos for you. Model Context Protocol. And yes, I know, I'm sorry if I have ambushed you with yet another video about MCP. There is tons of them explaining how it works, but don't worry, in this video we'll not be talking about the theory, we'll just focus on practical examples how you can use it. The only thing you need to know from the theory point of view is that MCP is a protocol that is intended to connect your chatbot with external software, such as Airtable. So let's start with the first element, chatbot. So at the time of the recording, if you don't want to get into a crazy developer tools territory, pretty much the only option you have is Claude. If you are on a paid plan, you can connect it to MCP servers. If you don't want to do the paid plan, you can always have the option of using Claude Desktop, which allows you to connect to MCP server even on the free plan. Now, how do we get access to a MCP server? We can look at the usual suspects such as make.com, and you can see that they offer an option to create MCP servers, but in their case, they're strictly linked to a specific scenario or scenarios. So that means we would have to configure scenarios, which was not what I was after. We can also look at another option, Zapier. Zapier offers MCP servers. You can set up a server and you can add different tools to it. So if we look at Airtable, it allows you to add the standard Zapier actions, but it doesn't have what I was looking for, actions that allow you to create tables and create fields within those tables. So this is not something that I can use to build a base from scratch. When you look on the internet, you also find open source projects that are a little bit more advanced in terms of feature that they offer, but because they are all in code, they are not really that straightforward to use. So in this case, we decided to bite the bullet and we have developed our own MCP server. It is based on one of the open source projects and it's fairly straightforward to use. I will show you how to use it in a second, but let's finally go back to our Claude and let's see whether this does anything. So you can see that we have an empty Airtable base with just one empty table, and our prompt says create project management base for company so-and-so, that is a contract manufacturer producing healthy food products. You can see that at the bottom, I also said explain the data before executing. So the reason for that is that I just want to see what it will create before it actually starts modifying the Airtable. And you can see that it's proposing the table structure. So you can see that this is project table, clients table, products table, task table. Well, that looks not too bad. I would say it's a little bit too much. It also offers some of the initial relationship, meaning projects would link to multiple clients, or the other way around, clients could link to multiple projects, and then one project could link to many different products. That looks pretty good. Let's tell it to create the initial tables only so that we don't create everything at once. And you will see that it asks me whether it's allowed to use this specific MCP tool called list basis, and I'll bite the bullet and I'll say allow always. Now it asks me the second command, which is create table. And here you can actually see in details what is the description of this request. And you can see that it will be creating phone field and the address field. And you can see that it's actually specifying the correct data types. And it's also specifying, for example, like the single select choices, and we'll bite the bullet and it will say allow always. Here you can see that in the previous request list basis, it has discovered that it has access to the base called testing MCP Airtable. And now it is creating additional tables. And do we see this inside of our Airtable? Yep, I have refreshed the Airtable and you can see that actually those tables are being created. I'll delete the table over here. So you can see that we already have the clients table, we have contact people, we have the phone number, we have address, We have a contact status, active, inactive, terminated. That looks pretty good. We have notes, and then it actually has created a linked field that links to projects. Look at that. Here we have project table. Let's see what else it's doing over here. That looks pretty good. We also have the team members, department. Actually, let's ask it to seed some initial data. So let's get some initial data inside of the base. You can see, because I have not used create record tool yet, it will ask me as well per tool whether it's allowed to do that. So let's say allow always. And you can see that the clients are being created. This is pretty much like working with API, but more fun. Let's wait for all the additional data to be created. You can also see that it's actually creating links between the team members and clients and different projects. All right, so you can see that it has created all the data that we have requested. Now you can see that there is a summary of all the projects, all the tasks, and so on. And you can see that we have actually ready-made Airtable with projects, tasks, team members, and all different statuses. So we could basically start working from here and, let's say, modify this. Now let's see if we can actually read the data in some creative way. It looks like it's writing some sort of React code for my chart. Wow, and I have a dashboard that summarizes how many hours are being used by the projects, and you can see that we have estimated an actual hours over here. We can see the estimated total of hours. We can see how many active projects we have. Oh yes, we could have 3 active projects. And then we have a chart that shows estimated time use per project. So we can have a health maple granola, and then we can see the nature choice, and we can see the actual and per project, and we can see the time distribution, and we can also see summary by the project and key insights. Wow, that is that is pretty impressive. So I am very impressed. Let's try one more thing. We'll ask it to create Airtable interface with similar charts. Well, luckily it turns out that it still cannot create Airtable interfaces through the API, because there's no API over there. So I think my job in building Airtable tables is done. Luckily, it turns out that you still cannot build Airtable interfaces through an API. So if you would be looking to build some nice interfaces for your business, check out the video that is linked in the description below, or reach out to Business Automated and we'll help you build amazing interfaces that work with your business. But coming back to MCP, now the question is, this seems to be pretty practical. So how to use it? So now the practical side, how to use it in your own Claude. The website we have created for this is called airtable-mcp.businessautomated.com, and this is purely for educational reasons, so the functionality is fairly basic. You can see that I have a MCP server link that is unique to me, that has a unique ID over here, which you should not share with other people, but I'm going to delete it and it will stop being valid. So it's not valid anymore. What it requires from you is to create a new server using your personal access token. So you can see that I have pasted the token, and based on that, I have created new link. This link is valid for 24 hours, just because we set it up this way. This is purely for educational purposes. Airtable will come up with MCP servers likely within a couple of weeks, days, months, and so on. So that's just for you to play with it and so on. So you can play with this. It will expire by itself within 24 hours, or you can just come back to the website and delete it over here. Now, how to create the PAT token? So you can go to airtable.create/tokens, where inside of the developer settings, you will see all the list of tokens that you have generated, and then you can create new token over there, give it appropriate name, select most likely all of the credentials. We're not doing anything about the comments, so those could be ignored. You will need the read-write for the data records. You also need the read-write for the schema, especially if you want to create new tables and new fields and so on. You can always adjust the permissions later. And here, again, this is for educational purposes. Do not add all the resources here. Add a specific base and pick the base that you would like to use for testing. And Once you have this, create the token. It will show up for you only once. You can then use it, come back to the website over here and generate this link. Once you generate this link, there are two ways to use it inside of Claude. If you use Claude online, claude.ai, you can click here on the tools and you can add integration and add integration over here and just copy paste the URL over here. Now you can see that we have this custom integration over here. We can see the permission and all the tools that are available, and we can go back to a new chat. You can see that Airtable is enabled here. We can disable all of them or pick a specific one, and we can ask, for example, all right. And if you are using Claude Desktop, it is a little bit more complicated. So you need to go to the settings, and once you open the settings, you'll basically see developer settings, and over there you can click edit config. When you click edit config, it will open a folder with the JSON configuration file. And you can open this JSON configuration file inside of your notepad. And this is the code that you need to add inside. We're using something called MCP remote as a way to remotely access this. So again, this is a little bit more complicated, but you should be able to test it out on the free plan. So that's it. That is everything. Let me know how you guys like it, whether you think this will be useful for you, whether it will change the way you guys work with Airtable. And yeah, please test out our website. Let me know how you guys are liking it. And thank you very much for your time.